never went back to it.
Okay, that's fair, because I could have done more reading. I won't deny that. However, still, what the information that you get given on these videos here at Speaker's Corner, or even by fellow brothers when you join the fold, should it not be reliable information?
You should. Definitely
so if that if that information proves false, isn't that a reason then to question Islam? For instance, put your hand up if you've been told that there's only one Quran. There you go, all of you. How many of you know about the Hafswash and Duri Quran?
Hafswash and Duri?
Hafswash and Duri.
I've heard of the different Qura'at and the translations.
Thank you very much. So, and they have different words, don't they?
Meaning the same thing.
They have different translations.
No, different words don't mean the same thing.
Look at the readings. Is that word the same as that word?
So you are talking about Ahruf, okay? He's talking about the Qur'ats that are officialized, minimum of 14 Qur'ats, but in 900 there were 50 different Arabic Qur'ats. So I want you to, okay, find the hadith for me, which you say there were 7 recitations.
Listen to what I'm saying. Pharaoh, when he said, let me kill Moses, what does he say? I'm going to translate it to you. And Pharaoh said, let me kill Moses. Yeah, this is in the Quran. And let him call upon his Lord. Indeed, I fear that he will change your religion and that he will cause corruption in the land. Okay? He will cause corruption. What does it say? In your religion, or that he will cause corruption in the land. It's the same thing. He's saying the same thing.
No, and or is not the same thing.
What is this word?
Read that.
What?
Kutila.
What does it mean?
Kutila.
Killed. Someone has been killed. So prophets are being killed. Okay. What is this Arabic word?
وكأي من نبي قاتل.
Okay, this sound is different other versus other one.
Different translations of the Quran.
No, we're talking about the Arabic. We're not talking about the English. We're talking about Arabic.
In Arabic, there's no difference.
No, there is. There are. I'll give you an example.
Can you see this extra letter?
Oh, la mastum. This is
la mastum. Yes. So there is extra A.
It doesn't matter.
It's not a
look like that. Look at the difference.
Look there.
What does the tag of Aleph do? Is that not a tag of Aleph?
Okay, come. You said the Arabic.
Here, here. A little bit. Come here.
Yeah, this one is the wash. And this is what it says.
It's totally different. Really.
It's totally different.
Yeah.
Thank you. So if you go to Morocco, they use this one. If you're here, they mainly use this one. One is wrong. Thank you. But Quran is inviting us, non-believers, to look in the Quran because it says if it's from God, there's no contradiction. And I've just shown you one. Is the meaning the same?
I'm not an Arabic expert. That's
you speak Arabic. You said at the beginning, you see? At the beginning you said you speak Arabic. When I've shown it to you, now you don't understand Arabic.
He said ban every Quran except for the Quran that there's a long story. I have to tell you.
Alright. So there was differences and that's why they killed him.
No, there was no difference. The Saudi Quran is the right Quran and it's the Quran that we read every day.
And what about the other one?
And it's never been changed.
And what about the other one?
I've told you, the other ones is a Quran is exactly the same. But
here you can clearly see when there's no dots, the letters are exactly the same. So he's lying because it's only because some of these are there that he's been able to understand it. But here we see with the dots, and once you take the dots out, you cannot read the letters. So what he said was a lie. My point is Muslims say that Quran is perfectly preserved and I'm saying it is a lie because we're seeing differences in Quran. So why would I become a Muslim if I'm seeing contradictions? Because Allah said, if it wasn't from anyone other than Allah,
you get the answer, you become a Muslim.
I'm waiting for an answer.
So this is not Quran. This translator of the Quran. So they tell you what
the
Quran
is. So Arabic is not Quran anymore. All he has been reading is the Arabic part. And now we identified Arabic part of Yusuf. Yusuf Ali is not Quran. Okay.
Here we have Nushra, as a good tied-in. To disperse, is that meaning the same?
I'm not going to look at the English because the English is...
Yeah, read the Arabic.
The Arabic says Bushra.
Yeah.
And this says Nushra.
Is the meaning the same?
I don't know the Arabic. Does anybody speak Arabic here?
This is Lamastum. No, not that one, sir. You can't even find out this one, okay?
Lamastum.
And then in here. So Lamastum. Can you tell me why this one has extra letter while this one doesn't have extra letter?
Where is extra letter? Wait.
And it is he who sends the winds to disperse before his mercy.
So is that the same as tomato and tomato?
look.
Is that the same as tomato and tomato?
No, it's not the same.
Thank you very much.
No, but
that's what you said originally it was.
Okay.
If he said something and someone said something, but it's exactly the same meaning, but Shakespeare says it in a different way. Do you understand? But I'm not trying to say he said it like that. But do you see what I'm trying to say? Do you see what I'm trying to get?
Going back to this point that there's only one Quran, I'm not involved in the movement that was using that as a way to say that we don't.
You don't believe that?
No one's denying there's different qira'at of the Quran. No one is denying that. It's been brought. Everyone knows this.
You recite in Morocco. You recite the Walsh Quran. Okay. This guy doesn't recite Walsh. He recites the Hafs. Okay. How can there be still one Quran?
I do Hafs as well.
Do the Hafs as well as the Walsh. That's already makes two Qurans. What is this one?
Qutila.
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 This is the right one.
Okay, this is the right one. This is the mistake. Okay, this Quran is the mistake. This Quran is the mistake.
Listen to what I'm saying.
I agree with you. There is contradiction.
There's contradiction.
Yeah.
So it can't be from God.
It can't be.
They're
you
from
show
the
me
reading.
Two things. It's two different readings.
Yes.
There is, of course. So listen to this.
So you admit there's contradiction?
Yeah, there is.
You're basically become an apostate.
Yeah, whatever you say.
Okay, that's good.
But I want to ask your question.
How can you trust Muhammad?
Today, the message is, look, we're trying to have a nice discussion with you, yeah? Do you see what's happening here? Do you think that this is, do you think that's the chief teaching of Jesus?
Would you like an autograph?
Yes, please. I love actually. Can
I sign
your
picture?
The Sabur.
Hello.
So basically, I've been speaking to many Muslims about the Qiraat and the Aruf. So I'm trying to find someone who is of knowledge who can adequately explain what it is.
Are you of knowledge on this topic?
I want to learn.
Sorry?
I want to learn.
Okay. So I'll find you someone.
But you're a Christian, aren't you?
You will find me someone.
I want to talk about the whole thing. I want to explain those 700 variations as well as the homes. Why does it exist? That's Yasir Qadi's Quran. I found it. Yasir Qadi's Quran, sir.
Mansour. I've been, many Muslims have been asking me to speak to
you. We have boycotted you for your mannerism, learn some manners.
But when I was on the live stream, I wasn't being boycotted. So how come it's changed since then?
It was a mistake.
I was a mistake.
Now, realizing.
I've been realizing, okay.
I'll tell you
okay, can
nervous.
I finish?
Because
can I finish? Can
I just
finish?
Exposed you right
can
now.
I finish?
You are here.
Can I finish?
Be nice to me.
Okay.
I know what you're on,
okay.
And I'm not going to speak to you.
You're not going to speak to me.
Yeah, look, turn the camera up. We'll talk.
All right. No, wait. This is what I want to ask you, Ali.
You're not going to get your soundbite.
Wait, this is what. No, no, wait. Just listen to what I've got to say because
Qutila is killed.
Yeah.
Okay. And what is in this one?
Save us from that.
What is in this one?
That's it.
It's Qatala. Is the same? Is the same word? It's the same word.
So if it is the same word, why are you pronouncing them differently?
In Hafs they said mu'minin, in Walsh we say mu'minin. So it's similar.
You already gave me two names of two different Qurans. And you are telling me it still makes one. I teach maths, it doesn't make sense to me. How can
So now Muslims say, like Yahya, we say 1 + 1 + 1 equals 1. But here we have 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 = 1. So how are you telling me there's one Quran? Look.
I can re-summon it. It looked like there was a Tiger Alif.
Alif!
Different.
This is different?
Different word.
No, say it. Is it different?
Yeah.
You need to. You know, pronoun, vocabulary, adjective and all that. It's just that. It's like, how can it, you know when you've done poetry, Romeo, Juliet, you know.
See, he's not explaining it, and this is why
I'm explaining it.
We have
Romeo,
holes
no, it's
in
not
the
holes.
Standard narrative.
You know Romeo and Juliet.
Look how desperate you,
see? You
are, you're talking to our backs.
No, but we've got witnesses. Okay, guys, let me explain to everyone. I've come to ask about the difference between Qiraat and Aruf. And they do not want to discuss it. I was talking to these young gentlemen here, and they said, go and ask someone of knowledge. So I'm saying to them, I have tried to speak to people of knowledge, but they are not engaging in the conversation. So don't blame me if I'm speaking to lay Muslims, because I've gone to every single person in this park, and he's using a straw man reason to say I don't want to discuss with him.
And Muslim scholars cannot explain to us why there are different Arabic Qurans. It's the same thing you get to hear even from scholars. They cannot explain to us, and they simply say there are holes in the narrative. It's not funny, actually. This book affects your eternity, and you think it's laughable.
If you're saying that the Quran is an eternal, unchanged, uncreated book that was revealed directly by Allah to Angel Gabriel, to Muhammad, and then written down by scribes, he says yes. So I do know what Muslims believe about the Quran.
But
if those Qurans are different, then that means that the human has interfered in the transmission of the text. But textual criticism is now being done to the Quran. And what have those same textual scholars found about the Quran? That there are different Qurans. So why does Yasser Qadhi, an expert of the Quran, say that you can't just take a blank book and write down what Muhammad revealed? I'll tell you why. Because he knows that there are variants as well, and we can't trace those variants back to Muhammad. That's why he said that. The fact of the matter is, we don't believe about the Bible what you believe about the Quran. What you believe about the Quran means that textual variance in the Quran is a problem. What we believe about the Bible means that textual variance in the Bible is not a problem.